Hello everyone, I'm Cool Guy. Welcome back. Season of the Worthy is here. A lot has changed, there's a lot to talk about, and with each season, new exotics come out. So today, I want to take an in-depth look into the new exotic warlock helmet, Fellwinter's Helm. It's a very interesting exotic. You can do a lot of different things with different subclasses, and this is going to be a deep dive into applications for it. I'm going to kind of walk through it, how I walked through the Controverse Hold. There's my thoughts throughout the review, but my goal here is to show what you can do with it, because that's half the battle, knowing what it's doing, when you proc the perk, what's actually happening in that moment, and as a player, what you can do to capitalize on it. I've worked with it for about 10 hours straight, I feel very comfortable talking about it. And with what I'm about to show, I think that this is a must-have. It does have a place in both PvE and PvP. The trick, though, is just to know what it's doing and how to use it. There are a lot of ways to use it, and this helmet does interact differently with whatever melee that you're using. Fellwinter's Helm is a neutral exotic, meaning it can be used on any warlock skill tree. Its exotic perk is Warlord's End. Arc, Solar, and Void melees create a burst of energy that weakens nearby enemies. Finishers and kills against more powerful enemies increases the radius of the burst and the length of the weakening effect. When you have a charged melee or when you use a finisher, that's when you use its main exotic perk, Warlord's End, a regular non-charged melee will not work. As I go through the review, I'm going to bring up this diagram, the circle. I'm going to build on it as we go, and by the end, there's a certain way you should think about this exotic perk. As you use your finisher or charged melee, a burst wave goes out. It's not instant, it's an actual wave. And once the wave touches the enemy, that's when it works. I'll talk about it more in the PvP section, but it's basically working like a bubble, multi-directional, up and down, left and right. The enemies that are caught within that bubble, as that wave goes out, are debuffed. When they're caught in it, they're stunned initially, almost like they're smoked. The stun effect is similar to Shattering Strike from the Hunter. You can easily tell which enemies are hit with it, and those are going to be the ones that you need to prioritize. While the enemies are this purple color, they're debuffed, you deal 30% more damage to them. What's nice about using it in PvE is that you can use it with your finisher at any time. You can just keep doing it over and over when your finisher can be used on an enemy. The tier of enemy is going to depend on how long it's going to last and how far it's going to pulse out. Now for the distances, I'm showing it here in the Tribute Hall. I've tried it in different places. The actual distance is really hard to judge. I do have an estimate though. Don't really hold on the number that it travels in PvE. And the actual number really doesn't matter, because if they get hit, you saw that they got hit by it. They're debuffed. For a common red bar, the wave looks to go out about 10 meters. The enemies caught in the debuff around are debuffed for around 9 seconds. The next tier of enemy, I estimate this wave goes out about 15 meters, and the enemies around that are hit are debuffed for 15 seconds. The next tier up, the range is massive. I estimate it's about 22-23 meters, and again, that could be close, it could be way off, but it's above 20. Just know that it's a large area. The enemies that are debuffed, that get caught, are debuffed for 20 seconds. It feels like an eternity. It's a very long time. You're going to be doing 30% more damage. Next up, the yellow bar bosses. You can't finish them, so I wondered, what about a charged melee? I tried different things versus different bosses. It doesn't appear to work on them. Every other enemy, though, it can be. And in a moment, I'm going to go over the melee interactions and then PvP, but really quick for PvE usage. Obviously, the jury's still out, it's very new, it's still fresh, but on a personal note, I think that granting a 30% debuff to the area that you're in, almost on demand because you're landing a finisher, that's kind of special. That's how I look at it. At any time, you do a finisher, you debuff the area, 10 to 20 meters depending on the enemy. You stun all of them instantly, and then you can start mowing them down, and your fire team can do that as well. And maybe you mow down a mid-tier. It's going to be like a 20-second deal. So think about activities, this public event right now, and future ones. Think about legendary lost sectors, even higher tier activities that you get into. Know what this does. It does have a place. In simple terms for PvE, I think about it as I pretty much have a 30% debuff on hand because of my finishers. I believe that it does have a place. Let's move on to the Crucible, and this is where I'm going to show the melee and skill tree interactions. But first things first, when you land that charged melee final blow, it sends out the wave. It extends 15 meters. And it lasts for 10 seconds. In PvP, it also grants a 30% debuff. So for 10 seconds, your enemy's butter. So say you get hit by this, everyone that puts shots into you, it's almost as if they have kill clip on their guns. You just melt. It's a very good debuff for PvP. For Warlord's End, with how you want to think about it, this goes into PvE as well. You think of it like a bubble. Think Titan bubble, full three-dimensional sphere. You are the center point. When you land your final blow on an enemy, that wave extends out 15 meters in every single direction from center. So it has a 30 meter diameter front to back, side to side, up and down, every direction. That leads us to the next big thing about this exotic. It's really important to know it goes through walls. It also does in PvE as well. So enemies that are above you, on the other side of you, around a corner, below you, You could kill them in one area, and if any enemy is within 15 meters of you in the Crucible, anywhere, they get hit with it. And they're going to be hit for 10 seconds. Everyone on your team is going to deal 30% more damage to them, and they're easily identified when they're hit. And since it does go through walls, I kind of think of Fellwinter's Helm as the Gemini Jester's nightmare older brother. Because when you're hit by this thing, it's miserable. The timer goes on the screen for 9 seconds, remember 00 counts, so it's a full 10 second timer. It's like you're smoked, you can't see well, and I would say that your vision is smoked like this for about 7 out of the 10 seconds. So at that point it sets in, you can't really see well, you're debuffed, it's not a good look. Like in the starting clip, I hit the one enemy with the final blow. I knew it tagged the Bubble Titan. So yeah, I went in there, shotgun beat him down, shotgun beat him down, and you're probably thinking, why didn't he just shotgun you? Well, his screen was like this. He was inside of his bubble in his super, he had an overshield. Small note, real quick, for this exotic in PvP, you PvP players, I do suggest that you stat into strength. This is to get your charge melee every 32 seconds. Because if you're, let's say, only tier 4 strength, it comes back every 1 minute 8 seconds. If you're at tier 3, it's 1 minute 22. It's like a lifetime. You're not using it that much. So if you want to be aggressive, have a lot of use out of this exotic, I do suggest that you get your strength, your melee stat, as high as you can. Mine is at tier 10. For the skill trees, the melees do different things. Everything I go over, it does apply into PvE as well. So for Dawnblade, top tree, we have Celestial Fire. That's the spiral ranged melee. Know that for any ranged melee, the Warlord's End pulse comes from you, not the enemy. So if you're to land a final blow at a distance, the pulse won't travel from where the melee ended, where your final blow is. Instead, you can get those ranged melee kills, but the pulse comes from where you're standing, and that's actually a good thing. Any close enemy gets debuffed. Any enemy within 15 meters. Moving on to Middle Tree Dawn, it's top tier for it, and that's for PvE and PvP. Especially in the Crucible, because not only are you debuffing surrounding enemies, you're also empowering yourself because of the melee. You've seen a lot of background footage, you may have noticed I've been using a sidearm. That sidearm has Swashbuckler. I'm going for a melee final blow, why not have it? That way I get to a x5 immediately. So in this scenario, I get to a x5, I debuff my enemy for 30%, all that stacking. But with Middle Tree, I'm going even a step further. We're now stacking x5 Swashbuckler, plus the Empowered Melee, plus their debuff. It's insane, it's a very good combo. On to Bottom Tree, it has the Explosion Melee. When you land the charged melee final blow, they are kind of sent into a ball of fire. As you get the kill, it debuffs around the area. Now, enemies that are close can actually be caught by that enemy ball of fire. It has an initial impact explosion damage, and then it has burn tick damage. All of those things are doing 30% more, so it can burn them out. Pretty cool for CQC. Moving on to the Stormcaller, it has a crazy interaction with Top Tree. We have the Arc Web Melee, Chain Lightning. You could be in close quarters, have a low health enemy, melee one, so you're not landing the final blow on the enemy that you're aiming at, but it does chain, it could down the low health enemy that was around, maybe you didn't see them. That counts as a melee final blow, so at that point, it sends out the Warlord's End Pulse, you then debuff the area, and it might chain long enough to hit debuffed players, it's very cool. Middle Tree, Chaos Reach, remember that this is a ranged melee, so the pulse is actually coming from you. So even though you get some kills at a distance, once you land the final blow, the pulse comes from you and the area around you. Now, it does have the traces to help get your melee energy back, so it's actually really cool with this. Then we have Bottom Tree. This is the Rising Storm melee. The melee ability recharges your super grenade and melee ability, and you also have the Arc Buddy. Not a bad option. So you would debuff the area, and you would know which enemies are debuffed. You're going to be shooting your primary weapon. It's pretty much like you have Kill Clip on them, and the Arc Bunny's also putting in work. Pretty fun thing to do. And lastly, let's talk about the Void subclasses. We have Top Tree, the Slova. This is the Bloom Tree. Strike an enemy with this melee. It gives you some grenade energy. You also have Bloom on the final blow, and it's just chaos when you land this melee, because it can collateral nearby enemies with the Bloom explosion. It's also debuffing ones that are closer, but doesn't quite get collated by the Bloom. It's chaos. Middle Tree, Nova Warp. This one works really well. Melee grants a void explosion, and the same thing, even though you kind of throw them and push them away from you, the pulse comes from you if you get the final blow. And the perfect clip from what you saw earlier, I melee the first enemy, and I have a couple behind me. When I get the kill, yeah, the one that I meleeed is way out there, but it pulsed from me through the wall, and these enemies got debuffed. Then we just mow through them. To add to that, it also has Dark Matter. Getting those charged final melee blows, it also gives you some energy back, along with grenade and class ability energy. So at tier 10 strength, the build is at around 32 seconds on the timer. Dark Matter is going to almost half that, so you get it about 15 seconds later. It's a very aggressive subclass for it. And lastly, we have Bottom Tree, the Devour Tree. You're proccing Devour on a melee final blow, so you start regenerating health, kills restore health. For a duration after that, it's very good as well. I will say this, if you're an aggressive player and want to try it, One more time, I suggest that you commit to it. Get your strength as high as you can. That way you can do it more. It's going to happen more often. Then there's different perks like Dark Matter to help out a ton. I'm mostly using swashbuckler weapons, sidearms, SMGs, because since I'm going for melee final blows anyway, and remember, the Warlock melee is a meter further than any other class, I'm getting a x5 immediately to go up against an enemy that's 30% debuffed. It's perfect. You can also think about Monte Carlo, things like that. As far as shotgunning, it isn't really going to extend your range, but it is going to make it consistent 8.5 meters and in. Even if you miss a couple pellets, that's okay because they're debuffed. And if you're using it with a shotgun, even if you go down, get a final blow, send out the pulse, it's still invaluable to your team because you debuffed all the surrounding enemies for 10 seconds. Very good with a shotgun. Now, you can use what you like. Each of them can work. I do prefer swashbuckler weapons. As far as my personal favorites, Top Tree and Middle Tree Dawn. The Middle Tree with the empowered melee is crazy in the Crucible. For Void, I like Middle Tree. I've used Bloom, it's fun. I've used Devour, it's fun too, but Middle Tree has Dark Matter that helps out what you want to do tremendously. And for Storm, I like Top and Middle Tree. All of them work one way or another. It's going to be up to you to see what fits best. That goes for the Crucible and PvE. In PvE, I was running around with Illumina, healing, buffing, doing finishers, debuffing with the perk, throwing down wells. It was pretty fun. Time's going to tell how it's all going to end up, but for the Crucible, I think that it can work even in Trials. Getting a pick in CQC, throw out the melee, debuff the area, and if the other two are close and it's Trials, they should be, that's a big thing for your team. The main thing about stuff like this is just to know how it's working. That's half the battle. Just knowing that the people above and below, they're going to get hit. Knowing what their screen looks like, how much damage you're doing, what weapons you can pair. All that makes a world of difference. I believe that this exotic is strong. With the things that you can do with it and how it does it, it's an insane exotic to me. It really is. If you learned something or enjoyed it, don't forget to rank the video. It helps me a ton. If you're new here, remember to hit the subscribe button, ring the bell to get videos right as they come out. Thank you for your support. What do you think about Felwinter's Helm, the Nightmare older brother? Do you think that it can work in Trials? Maybe just for general play? And what types of PvE content can you see this really working? Thank you for watching, and until the next one, I am Cool Guy.